We all know some people out there that seem to have an inflated view of themselves. And when they do, that seems rather obvious. But then there's other people that struggle to maintain a healthy self of themselves, one which doesn't attach too much importance on the things that they say or the things that they do. You know, when people have a very high opinion of themselves and show that opinion to others, it gets attention, but often not in a good way. And my guess is that there are many of us who find ourselves on the other side, end of the spectrum, that go through life without drawing too much attention to ourselves, without being in the spotlight, without boasting or inflating our accomplishments or our qualities. And many of us, put simply, just go through life in a very anonymous way. We go through life in a very quiet, unassuming way. And you might even think to yourself, you know, I wonder if anything that I do will be remembered after I leave this earth. Wonder if the world will remain unchanged for having been here. And you might think when you speak about yourself that way, we're exercising humility. And humility is a virtue. And humility is a virtue that most of us would be wise to embrace, because we have to remember things like, we are not the center of the universe. We are not more important than anyone else. We're not in charge. And our opinions don't necessarily matter more than others. No, nor are we really any wiser about things in this world. Or are we more worthy of love, or of friendship, or of financial success, or of any other good thing? No, each of us, every single person, is on the same journey. And that journey is a search for peace and joy and hope and meaning. And every single one of us needs God and God's unfailing help to make our way through this life. And so each of our lives is no more important than the life of anyone else. And so living in the light of that profound truth can be humbling and it can be freeing. And the truth is, it's not all about me. And that's okay. And actually, it's more than okay. And yet, whether we are the kind of person who likes the attention or not, whether or not we think we are an indispensable kind of person, or a person who feels very forgettable, we are all in faith called to be something that many of us would never imagine. And for, in a certain sense, every Christian is expected to be astonishing. That's right, astonishing. Can you imagine that? Me, astonishing. Doesn't seem possible. But in today's readings, we see three examples of people who astonished others in their own way. First, we have the prophet Ezekiel, who was a man who accepted God's invitation to call the Jewish people to greater holiness and faithfulness. And he did so at the cost of great peril to himself, enduring anger and ridicule of the masses. Ezekiel didn't go about his life like everyone else. He didn't blend in. He didn't give into the way that things were. He chose a different path, and people were astonished. Paul chose a different path, and we know this story well. We know the story of his dramatic conversion experience, resulting in his willingness to travel all over the known world, telling people about the wonders of God that he's done through the person of Jesus Christ. And it wasn't just the things that he said that were different. He was different. And the communities he helped form lived much differently, with greater kindness and generosity. And it wasn't easy for Paul, but that didn't stop him. You know, in fact, his weakness, his faults, his own sins, and his willingness to admit them helped shine a light on the increasing goodness of God. And whether a person agreed with Paul or not, one thing was clear, that he was impossible to ignore, because his life was simply astonishing. And then, of course, we have Jesus. In today's gospel, we see him suffering the suspicion and the rejection of many who had known him his whole life. And yet the things that they heard him teach, the wisdom that he displayed, and the mighty deeds he wrought astonished them. And in a very real sense, Jesus was unlike anyone else that they had ever seen before. And as a result, everyone took notice, friend and foe alike. Now the question is, can we say the same thing about our lives? Now, in asking that question, it might make us feel a little uncomfortable, because it might sound like I'm saying that we need to be out there shouting loudly, "Look at me, look at me." But that's not it at all. What should be astonishing to others is not our eccentricities, it's not the volume of our voices, nor should it be because we're the kind of person to get up here to scold, or to criticize, or to put down, or to judge. Rather, it's the degree to which we display God things in a profound way that will get the attention of others and will hopefully astonish them. Astonishing levels of mercy and forgiveness, astonishing levels of kindness and generosity, astonishing levels of humility, astonishing levels of compassion and understanding and of love. These are the things that change the world. These are the things that will change the human heart. And these are the things that will get others to take notice, to pay attention, to pause, to reflect on what they are seeing, and maybe to embrace the very same things. And so being astonishing really has nothing to do with being in the spotlight or deliberately trying to get everyone's attention. No, each of us can be astonishing in our own way, even if our lives seem insignificant and invisible, even when we might feel just ordinary, even when we really can't see how we could possibly make a difference. But we always have to remember that recipe. That recipe is just love, and love, and love some more. People will notice, and they will be astonished.